Okay.
Hatsanas!
Gonna pop up in you! Dead soon.
Oh, it's got teeth, does it?
Oh, damn it. That's a lot of clocks. Here they come. This isn't looking good. Thank you.
It would seem this twisted world is not yet depleted of surprises. I greet you, then, and welcome you to the realm of the Fae, or what so remains. I am Numue, artisan, seer, goddess of the Fae, and counselor to the one true king. Or so I was. Still, it is my gift to see what cannot be seen, and to forge what cannot be forged. So then, strange one, what brings you thus before me? Like you, you say? You are a unique taste, strange one, unknown to me. But your form, perhaps? Yes, it is familiar. I may have seen this Clementine in dreams and visions. She wears your shape, yes. But she tastes different. Powerful. I have seen her in a kingdom of great authority, filled with doors and possibilities. But I do not recognize it, nor can I find the way. Not here, not as things are. The kingdom is in disarray, strange one. The one true king has been deposed, but the manner of his deposition has wrought unforeseen consequences for everyone. Now, an imposter sits upon the throne, a deceiver and a fraud. They must be slain if I am to fix what is broken, and, perhaps, if you are to find what you seek. I cannot ask this of you, but were you to accept this burden, to slay the deceiver, you would find them in the floors above, beyond an opulent door carved of their own vanity. And if I can provide you with wisdom or aid, you need only ask. As do so many, strange one. Ask, and I will answer. Oh, a place of great beauty. Palaces of gold, fields of green and blue and fuchsia. Cheerful glades lit with the songs of our people. You have not seen the like, strange one, for it does not exist. One can see hints of it here and there, intertwined with the dreary sphere that has since festered around us. I will find a way to restore it. Indeed, the seed of a plan has already been set in motion. Yet, So much remains mere hope and conjecture. Perhaps one day. To voice it would raise my hopes too far, or worse, belie how pathetic the plan truly is. No, better to reveal nothing for the nonce. The one true king rules this kingdom with an iron fist, mollifying his subjects with promises of freedom and prosperity. And to be sure, there was prosperity. For some. Those who did not offer praise and fealty, who did not share in the royal values, who were deemed unworthy in myriad ways, their prosperity was taken and given to the favored. It was freedom for some at a cost to many. And eventually, there were some who sought to plot against him, and so, the tyrant was deposed, but at a cost. None, not even I, could have foreseen the consequences of our actions. The one true king truly was more intertwined with our realm than any knew. The one true king was not easily removed. Many tried. But he could not be harmed by mortal weapons forged and wielded by his own subjects. Indeed, so many had failed that it was deemed foolishness to oppose him at all. That perhaps our very world relied upon his rule. This turned out to be true. The imposter, however, fears only weakness. They turned the ear of the king's confidants, convincing them that freeing the people was worth any risk. Swayed by their words, a plot was made to remove the king from power. Only at the last second did I realize their mistake. And our people suffered the more for it. Much must be accomplished to remedy what was despoiled. But first and most critically, the imposter king must die. It is amusing that you think I owe you anything at all, strange one. I have told you all that I wish to, just as you have told me all that you wish to reveal about yourself. The deceiver is eternally self-absorbed. They have seated themselves in palaces of conceit on gilded thrones of falsehoods. You cannot fail to find them. For they have ensured that all roads lead to themselves. Certainly, strange one. It is as you say. Indeed, it is so. Even the poor creatures of these kingdoms twain can sense his passing. So great an influence he had over us all. Strange one, you have done what so many, never could. The Fae owe you a great debt, though they know it not. Perhaps I may now begin to mend that which has been sundered. And I hope you, also, may find that which you seek. The strange one returned. Namue's artisanship is your... Stay the path.
Thank you.
They're coming! Defend our home!
Attack them!
Huh.
dead soon.
Out of This isn't looking good.
Light him up!
Here.
Yeah. Thank you. Oh, God, behind us, thank you. Oh, they would have burned me alive. Thank you. Thank you. Oh, nothing. I only told them what I saw.
They see it too. I know they do. Creatures.
I see them everywhere. Not much bigger than a dren, but full of wings and teeth. They feed on us, stranger. The others? Oh, they see them too. Yeah, they'll fight them off, maybe avoid them while a dren dies at their feet, but then they do nothing. Move on like nothing happened at all. And when I tell them, well, I won't stop talking about what I know is true. So I think the better question is, why am I like this? Oh, it's a bloody curse, I tell you. There are others. I knew one, but I ain't seen her in weeks. After what happened today, I expect I know what happens to any of us who talk about what we see, what we know. Well, nothing's safe here in any case. Thanks again, stranger. And watch yourself.
I've got enough of that.
Such as yourself, We'll have less trouble finding such a being. Stay the course. I feel right certain you'll find what you're looking for. Of course. Ask me anything you want, my dear. It was an unexpected patch, I'll admit. Stitched in all of a sudden, like. But now that it's here, I do believe it's the patch we needed. Oh, don't hear me sideways, Tyr. I know it ain't all fancies and fortunes. Some of these creatures are feeding on the poor Dran. And the Dran, well, most of them can't see or refuse to see what's happening. It must be terrifying for all. But it's growing pains. Mark my words, once the stitching's done, we'll be right as rain. Indeed. Truth is, some folk only ever see what they want to see. For if they open their eyes to the facts, it'll mean ripping out every stitch left holding them together. So, I understand those what can't see, but their blindness makes things so much worse for the rest. Those what can see have it terrible. They can't ever go back to the way things were. But there ain't no one to give them the help they need. Have mercy on them, dear. Until the stitching's done, they more than most bear the terrible, unwanted burden of the truth. Ah, that. I've been given eyes to watch over my people, and a heart to protect them. But no voice of my own in exchange. To speak to my people, I must speak through them. That is the way of it, my children. Now, they are those what got nowhere else to go. But they choose me, and I'm mother to them more than any other Dran. I am sorry if it's disturbing, but do understand, these children are willing speakers on my behalf. Goodness, no! For all my gifts, that ain't something I could do even if I wanted. But they ain't got no compunctions about speaking for me. Makes them feel important, it does. Didn't I already tell you, my dear? Aye, that's it there. Sure as sugar, life's the quilt, and the quilt is life. And we're all part of the patchwork. None can see the whole till the whole is done. All we can do is stitch it in, one patch at a time. This patch is what ain't been stitched in yet. But that don't make them less a part of the whole. It just means the quilt ain't finished. Like these children here, stitched to their parents. Though, their parents ain't around no more. And they were stitched to me too before we met. For all Dran are a part of each other. Quilt and Dran are the same, my dear. And not just the Dran, we're all this quilt. It's just that all the patches ain't been sewn in yet. And maybe never will be. At least, not in a single run-through. Life's just a rehearsal for something else, isn't it? It might feel like we only get the one run at it, but there's so much more. And some of us get more than that, don't we? You live and die and live again. But it's all part of the same quilt. Every patch of your life's telling a single story. And when your patches end, another's will be sewn in. And so the quilt continues, on and on, until it's complete. Oh, we'll know when we know. Until then, we just keep stitching in our stories, one patch at a time. Aye, the paths are the same.
Thank you.
Okay, this is it. Not enough room.
Strange indeed. How can I be of service? Namue's artisan. Stay the path. The strange. As. Certainly. Farewell for...
Okay.
Yeah. Whoa.
It was rough.
All right.
Let's do this. That's ominous.
Yeah.
Here they come. Take that.
Enter, mortal. Lives such as yours are too short to dally with hesitancy. Know that you stand in the presence of the divine, the true heir to all that surrounds you, and the only one who can stand against the imposter who claims the throne. You may not be of the Fae, benefits of this kingdom with every breath. No, strange one, but these lands and their people draw their life from my own, and shall do so eternally. For none have stood against me and lived. It is my hallowed duty to rule and watch over my subjects, just as it is the duty of my subjects to serve. Now that we share this understanding, I will accept your tribute as one who serves. You are not Fae, and so perhaps are unaware of the offense which you commit. I will stay my hand but once. All must sacrifice for the greater good. My burden is to protect, and my subject's burden to bestow honor. Though you be not Fae, you yet profit from my blessings. Thus you are either my subject or a thief. Perhaps even a spy of that imposter. Your next words determine which is the truth. You insult me. Better to have refused tribute at all. For this offense, you must die. I am a prince among thieves. I'm worthy. It is my hallowed now that we sh. If you shall not offer tribute as one who serves, then you shall die as one who does not. This hall shall be your grave!
To me, trapped with the wrong girl. Woo! Ha ha!